Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Jesus had just finished the miracle of feeding 5,000 men, plus women and children, with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. Jesus had the disciples go into a boat while he dismissed the crowds, go up to a mountain to pray alone in the evening. The disciples continued going to the other side in a boat, now being battered by the waves from the wind against them. After the middle of the night, Jesus came toward the boat walking on the sea. The disciples were terrified and crying out in fear, thinking they were seeing a ghost. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him, "Lord, it is you. Command me to come to you on the water." But Peter, seeing the strong wind, and began to sink and cried for Jesus to save him. Immediately Jesus reached out his hand, caught hold of him, and said to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" Jesus and Peter went into the boat, and the wind ceased. And the disciples worshiped Jesus and said, "Truly, you are the Son of God." Let's look at some passage points. First, we're not alone. The disciples were probably feeling lonely and scared as the storm raged around them, and this ghost was walking on the water. They couldn't see Jesus clearly. Sometimes we feel alone, but the Bible tells us God is with us wherever we go. Second, what is there to fear? The disciples cried out in fear of what was happening. Sometimes we are fearful of what is going on around us or to us. The Bible says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the defense of my life. Whom shall I dread?" And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Third, keep the faith. Peter showed tremendous faith walking on the water toward Jesus, but he became distracted, causing him to sink. We too must keep our vision and focus on Jesus despite life's distractions. For everyone who has been born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world, our faith. You are from God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he who is in you than he who is in the world. Stay firm in the faith, knowing God is full of grace and has called us to his eternal glory in Christ. Fourth, we are shown compassion. Despite Peter losing focus, Jesus showed compassion by saving him. The Bible mentions many acts of compassion shown by Jesus. The ultimate act of compassion was Jesus dying on a cross for our sins, so that we might live with him. Is our 2020 vision focused on Jesus? The world offers us power, fame, fortune, and many other things. Jesus offers us eternal life through him. We are called to have faith to be overcomers. 1 John 5:5 says, "Who is it that overcomes the world? Only the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God." Every one of us has made mistakes. But as Paul tells us, forget what is behind, look forward to what is ahead. We are not to be conformed to this world, but to be transformed by the renewing of our mind. How do we not be conformed, but be transformed? By keeping our vision on the things from above. Do that by reading the Bible, praying, attending a Bible-believing church, and other things that get our minds and spiritual sight focused on Jesus. If your 2020 vision isn't focused on Jesus, it can be. Please click on the Salvation Prayer button to find out how. God bless you.